were feeding goats. And the grass is really sharp and keeps cutting my hand. But it's a very sweet experience.
How do you know when something's for you? Like for me, whenever I get a feeling upon seeing something, I usually get like this very clear sensation that I need to go and do that thing. So for instance, I was driving past goats and I knew that after school I would have to bring the girls to hang out with them. And we did, and it was amazing. Like it was really absurd.
Gathering flowers for the goats because the grass is so sharp it's cutting my hand. That's the survival mechanism that the grass uses.
So this was the best way for me and the girls to work through our heavy Saturn and Capricorn energy lovingly, and to nurture life and to just pay attention. These goats were so sweet, and we were with them for like 3 hours. I ended up picking up my other daughter and we came back and were feeding them just high vibration goat contact. The hardest part was definitely when the goat, like this big guy, started fighting everyone for grass, and then there was like a family of like non-activated people who were just like mistreating the goats, and then they got a little feisty and we had to bounce. But we had been there for 3 hours, so it was time.
So we're going to the beach. The girls are crying as usual. We're a caterpillar.
Decided to take a break from ordinary. I
rather than just be like, oh, let's go to Baldwin, I was like, let's go to the secret turtle cove that like no one knows about. And I'm walking on a rocky coral-filled area, barefoot of course. There's a marvelous sunset. There's like 50 turtles here in the cove.
We are being helped by some people. Some people initially came up, but they didn't work back here. And I'm making another painting, but this time on linen rather than canvas because that's been like the trend. Maybe we can even find some clear gesso here, which would allow for the people to just see that brown color. Home Depot, it's great.
This is water.
I'm trying my best to incorporate the girls into a lot of my art projects and to help them to see the real tasks required to complete things that we need to do. And a lot of this I'm learning also to love more of my day-to-day, like to not hate it. And managing my own time as an entrepreneur, someone who's starting their own sort of business, has really encouraged me to to take more time and be outside and enjoy what I have manifested, because it's like worlds away from what I was doing in Brooklyn. It's really good for my nervous system.
This is post, oh my gosh, I broke my fast and I just had like the most delicious food. My husband told me today there are like 50,000 people, if not more, subsisting completely on prana. So they don't consume liquids, they don't consume food. They consume energy through like breath and presence, so that's exciting. As I was breaking my fast today, I thought, could I continue this? But I was already drinking, like, I started with coconut lemon water in the middle of the night, and
Then I had tea at this amazing rosehip apricot tea. I have food in my face, excuse moi. I literally put the spoon in my mouth with like avocado and protein powder. I was so hungry. So I'm still in the dichotomy of I like to eat food and what's up with these people who don't eat. Like, that's where I'm at. And I was listening to the Char channel, and he spoke to veganism and how this woman, she got really ill and she was vegan and she doesn't want to be consume animals. And he said that it's because she's like in this state of mind to where she judges people who eat animals or don't. And that's what limits her from taking that next step and elevating in her capacity to appreciate both and just know that one's not better than the other, because they're not. It's just that a chemical process has to happen because she's living in that belief. So for me, I've been plant-based and I've had fish a few times. But this year so far I haven't, and I was thinking about it just to kind of like make sure I'm pono with myself, that I'm like, I'm not just doing it to do it. And while I'm not sure, because I'm not going to make any promises ever about food or not eating, I did think about it today and I was like, do I want poke? Am I going to break my fast with poke? And then I was like, not really, I can have a chai. So I went and had chai tea, and I got such beautiful confirmation from a sister who, she's taking the artist way, she's a poet, and she was like, your samba came to me at the right moment, because she's going through a breakup. And I just felt so touched and happy. A gorgeous time to see butterflies. But yeah, I feel that my sound bath on Sunday is going to be epic. I just went through all of my artwork and repriced it accordingly, just because I was making up random numbers and like valuing it based on like what I thought it could sell at. But now I'm just sticking to the square inch model. So you take the length, you multiply it by the width, and then that is for $1 per square inch. So you would add more money if you're gonna charge $3 per square inch, or $8 or $20 per square inch, which I look forward to doing eventually. But it would just to be to create this amazing project that I'm envisioning and seeing, because I've found that there's never been an adequate way for me to study butterflies. Like, I love them, I'm sure billions of people do, but I've just never found a really tight way. I don't live near an observatory now, but I do live in what I'm calling butterfly country. And I just drew one in black, like in grayscale with charcoal. And it felt really good to do that. But I was like, I don't understand why their wings form this pattern. Like, I get it, if it's like from a caterpillar, the pattern that's on them ends up becoming the wing. And it goes into like this crystalness of, you know, a ground animal being able to fly. They're all over today. Hello. Magical. Hi. How often do you let your intuition guide you? I'm working on more frequently.
It's been a while. I miss Tokyo.
When I look back to my life in New York in a lot of reflection, as I have quite a lot of space to do so, I almost can't believe it. Like, it feels like it was like a nightmare that I couldn't wake up from, a self-imposed nightmare. And also, I'm so grateful for my time there and the people I met, the lessons I learned. I traveled a lot when I was living in New York, so it was sort of like my jump-off point. but I would have like recurring dreams of these big open spaces. And even just now, you know, of course, Maui's going to change in the coming years because the world population is growing and people need housing. They need space. They need places to live. But to be able to go out into this pasture and to see no one, it's like my soul needed that. And I did have glimpses of it. I had retrospectively, I made artwork that kind of depicted this exact place. But my consciousness didn't have an assignment for it. There was nothing in me that was like, oh yeah, this is the next sequential step to live on indigenous land and to honor my body and to get to know my heart and my soul like I've never done. It's a blessing. What a glorious one. Beautiful. Last night there was a night lark singing. It was so pretty. And for whatever reason, this won't focus on the tree. It's an amazing baby tree. I feel like God has been asking me to grow in ways past my comfort zones and to open my heart a lot more, which I've been doing my best. And I do sense progress. I sense growth and transformation because a lot of hard no's for me are now kind of like, okay, well, let's feel it out. Let's see how it feels, which I'm happy to do. I'm happy to work on ekadashi again because I kind of got into a comfort zone. And I feel like our comfort zones truly limit the ability for us to feel immense joy and purpose and passion. So I encourage anyone watching to test the boundaries of that comfort zone, see if they really work for you or not. Aloha.